Welcome to St. Mary's Now, a partnership between the Enterprise newspaper and the Forrest Center TV video production program. I'm Raymond Graham.
And I'm James King.
And here's the latest news from the Enterprise.
Property assessments in the central part of St. Mary's were up since the last review was made 3 years ago, according to a triennial report by the Maryland Department of Assessments and Taxation. 3 years ago, the 2nd, 3rd, 6th, and 9th election districts were reassessed and the values had finally stabilized following the recession and were holding steady with little fluctuation in values. At the time, residential properties went up about 0.5% and commercial properties by about 1%. Today, the same districts on average have increased in value 6.5% for residential properties and 10% for commercial properties. The state residential average is 7.3% and commercial average is 13.5%.
Town Creek Elementary School students in its after-school program collected hats, gloves, scarves, and socks for those in need. They turned over the collection to an outreach group on Monday, who will distribute those items to the community. Although the project was sponsored by the after-school program, the students sought the help of fellow classmates and the community members through word of mouth and by pasting posters about the drive to the school walls.
An employee at St. Mary's College of Maryland has been published in a statewide journal and is eager to share his discoveries after 2 years of intensive research and writing. Kent Randall, College Archivist of Information Science at St. Mary's, has published the first of four articles in a series about Maryland's stored Susquehanna Estate in the Maryland Geological Society Journal. The Susquehanna Estate was an important site in colonial Maryland history.
The county's health department has been hard at work coming up with strategies to make St. Mary's healthy and combat opioid and other substance abuse issues, and is requesting additional dollars for delayed renovation to its office in Leonardtown. At Tuesday's County Commissioners meeting, the St. Mary's County Health Department briefed commissioners on health topics of concern, agency updates, and the county health improvement process. Dr. Mina Brewster, the county's health officer, led the presentation. She told commissioners that opioid-related deaths are trending similarly to last year, in the county, and have grown sharply since 2007. Non-opioid-related deaths caused by cocaine or alcohol, however, have decreased since 2017.
Popular jazz artist and St. Mary's resident Latrice Carr will be opening for nationally known jazz acts at the summer's Potomac Jazz and Seafood Festival in St. Clements Island Museum in Colton's Point. Carr, a multi-genre singer and songwriter known for her soulful range and gospel roots, is thrilled to be the opening act, saying, "It is exciting to think that some of my best moments in life have not occurred yet, and this is definitely one of those moments. Being the opening act for the 2020 Potomac Jazz and Seafood Festival is a huge honor. The festival is expanding from a one-day event to a multi-day weekend celebration for 2020, and is planned for the 10th through 12th of July."
This news brief has been provided by the Enterprise. For more details, visit somdnews.com. That's what we have for you on this edition of St. Mary's Now. I'm Raymond Graham.
And I'm James King,
signing off.